if thus the Atman, the Self, is the cause for the whole universe of the not-self, what is its cause? Karanandara niras. There is no cause for him. He is not caused by anything. All these questions arise because all of our experiences are conditioned in time. In time alone, there is cause and effect. That which is earlier in time is the cause, and that which follows in time is called effect. Thus, the tree is the cause for the fruit that comes afterwards. But the fruit from which the seed rose, the fruit is the cause of the tree, and tree is the cause of the fruit. With the reference to the fruit, the tree is earlier, therefore the tree is the cause, the fruit is the effect. With reference to the tree, the fruit is earlier, therefore that is the cause. So who is the cause and who is the effect? You are an effect of the cause, the father. And you yourself is the cause for your children. So you are a son to your father. But you, the son himself, is the father to your son. Now I'm confused. Who are you? Father or son? You are both, but at the same time, something beyond both. Son and the father are two conditions of mine with reference to the father and the son. But when these relationships with the past and the future is ended, I am me. And I was playing the part of effect with reference to the future, past, and cause with reference to the future. Beyond time, this cause of the universe is beyond both cause and effect. Beyond both cause and effect means beyond time. So within time only this question comes of cause and effect, because the intellect is naturally. Intellect can function only in time and space. And therefore it is always asking the question, what is the cause, what is the cause, what is the cause? But when you are questioning the Narayana, who is beyond the time, your question is absurd. He is the one who is illumining both cause and effect, the assumptions of both cause and effect which are of the intellect. Intellect has these assumptions only with reference to the time. The intellect can function only in time, and therefore in all intellectual investigations, cause and effect is the method. Once you transcend the intellect, there is neither cause or effect. That consciousness is that which illumined for you the decisions of your intellect, that such and such a thing is the cause for such and such a thing which is an effect. By himself is neither karya nor karana. Bhavana, contemplate upon yourself that you are that self.